a little some type of way recently. Just a little depressed. I've been reading like a shit ton of Nietzsche. Is that how you pronounce it? Nietzsche. 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 Nietzsche.
Nietzsche. No.
Nietzsche. I saw somebody do this on YouTube some months ago. And basically they just painted their feelings. Kennedy Claire Walsh. And I was like, that is a great idea for, that is something I should do because I have a lot of feelings and also have none. Zero. Absolutely nothing is going on in here. It's okay though, because I think that if I painted the things I'm feeling, that I would feel better. We're just gonna let shit hit the canvas. We do actually have every single Bob Ross paint ever. Before Bob Ross was a big old trendy trend. Instead of, sorry, it's the kombucha, you know. Instead of summer camp, my father sent us to the garage and we would do the Bob Ross tutorials. And I will be using his paints and I will be disgracing them because I am not a visual artist. I need to, why the fuck am I wearing a white shirt? Oh, I swear to God, this is not gonna become my paint shirt. This is my new shirt. It has shoulder pads, and I'm fucking stoked about it. And if I ruin it with sallow blue, I'm gonna scream. I'm already unstable as it is. Oh my God. In all honesty, the Bob Ross paints would not be my first choice for today because I'm not a should have picked some acrylic stuff from Target if I'm being honest. Like, I'm a child. Okay, I really can't open the phthalo blue and it's gonna give me a hernia. I would say I'm two parts angry, four parts depressed. You know how I like make videos where I'm like, this is why you should live? They don't help. Those are moments, those are good moments I'm having. Those are like fleeting moments of, it's all worth it, okay? This is where I'm usually at. I'm usually down here. The fuck is this? I don't even care, I'm squirting it. I'm sat here looking at a million paints and not, oh, there's a blue. Okay, from that blue, I will make all other blues. They got child lock on this, so naturally I'm not gonna be able to get in. Okay. What actually gave me like more hope and life than anything has recently? The Wall Street takeover by the Redditors. That subreddit, Wall Street Bets, I've been a part of that for like, years. I don't go on Reddit very much anymore. I don't go on social medias too much anymore. I try to like limit myself. Like, I don't scroll for very long. I'll like pop on, look at the top post and be like, fuck this and get out. Like, I'm gonna emphasize one last time. I am not a visual artist. Okay. I'm not a painter. I don't, the beautiful scenes in my head never come out through my hand. There's no connection here. And you will find that out. I don't even have to tell you that. But anyways, I realized because lately I've been like, oh, I want to get off social media. But then I found out about this whole movement from the news. I was like, how am I 70? Am I 77? Since when do I read about what's happening on Reddit on the news? That pissed me off. It's like when you were reading about the Bernie Sanders memes on the news. No, I didn't need to go to the news for that. I saw it over my feed. That's what it's like to be a young person on social media. You don't find this shit out from the news. And that just made me feel really disconnected from all my people because I don't like, I'm major FOMO. Okay, major FOMO. I was like, well, damn. Do I want to hear about the highlights or do I want to be a part of them? And this is something I'm struggling with currently. So, for this emotion, I will be painting confusion. And what's more confusing than life? Life on Earth. What's more confusing than that? So, the first thing I will be painting is Earth. Now, Earth is actually really tiny. If you think about the entire universe, we're just a little, a pale blue dot, as someone once said. Is it Carl Sagan? I don't know. Earth. Earth. Nutty rock floating in the middle of nothing. In a tiny solar system. In a tiny little galaxy. In the vast unknown darkness. No perceptible end, no conceived meaning.
I mean, only conceived meaning.
If you have not already done so, you should watch that movie Soul on Disney Plus. It's a heart wrencher.
There was once a fish swimming upstream, and he stopped and asked somebody, "Hey, where's the ocean? I'm looking for the ocean." And the guy goes, "We're in the ocean." And the fish goes, "No, this is water. I'm looking for the ocean."
And this is the best thing I've ever heard someone say about, like, life on Earth. We are constantly searching for more. And my friends, we are never gonna find it. We have to love what we have right here, right now, and every little stinking moment of it. Okay, so I'm gonna hold off on adding that green. What shall I add next?
That's right, rage. I've been feeling a lot of anger recently.
I will now draw my anger. And this is how... That's supposed to be the middle finger. Okay, but tastefully done. There's lots of pain in anger. But you know what I love about anger? When you're angry at something, at least you fucking care. The worst is when I don't even fucking care. That's when I know I've simply given up.
Today I woke up depressed.
Okay. And you know what? God damn it.
I'm angry about it.
Because last night was a Friday night.
And what do we do on Friday nights?
Blitzed.
We get blitzed.
It's a great fucking time. But I didn't do it. Okay. I stayed sober.
I know.
Thank you.
I stayed sober and I had a great time. You don't need drugs and alcohol to have fun.
Absolutely not.
You just need the right people and a good mindset.
But truly why I didn't drink was because I didn't want to get depressed. Alcohol is a depressant and it's been proving that to me.
Okay, recently. I'm like, oh fuck. Every time I drink, I'm like, god damn. I'm like, why am I here?
So I was like, not today. I don't want to wake up depressed tomorrow.
What the fuck happens? I woke up fucking depressed. Tell me why that is.
I went on a run. I went and worked out.
But then I was like, because, you know, that happens so much. It's just like not even, I just expect it at this point.
And I was like, okay, fuck that. I'm pissed. I don't want to be depressed. I want to be living my goddamn life. So I just got mad about it. And then I'm angry. So, and then the fact that I got angry, I was no longer depressed.
You know, I think I did something in between, actually. So, never mind. I had a task, but then I got angry, retrospectively, about being depressed.
What does this look like to you?
I feel like this is coming out of somebody's mouth. They're just, like, shooting out rage.
Oh my god, you guys. This is really coming out really good.
I'm gonna draw a little, like, mouth. Wide open.
It's a Pac-Man, and it's puke green.
It's supposed to be yellow, dog.
Ugh, I hate painting.
All right, I'm just gonna start like letting the paint do its relaxing magic, okay? I'm just gonna, you know, we don't judge whatever comes out on this canvas, be it putrid yellow or the yellow of a sunset. We don't judge it. We don't love it and we don't hate it. We detach ourselves from emotion and judgment.
So what's been on your mind? I really wish you could talk back. You have no idea what it's like to just be the one rambling. Like, I don't stop talking this whole time.
I think it's okay to doubt yourself. Especially when you've been going at something for so long.
So what, you doubt your ability to get there?
Duh. If you didn't, like, what kind of human would you be? Narcissistic or delusional? Nothing wrong with that. But,
I mean, Kinda.
Oh my god, that's totally what I used to be. Are you ever like intentionally mean to someone to actually hurt them? Siblings don't count. You're allowed to do that. You're allowed to do that.
Like people on the internet that are just like mean? I do not understand that.
Okay, that's a lie.
I was really mean to Rebecca Black once. When her video Friday came out, I was like talking to this guy at the time, okay, in like fifth or sixth grade. And I thought it'd be really funny if I told her she sounded like a dying whale or something. So I commented that. I feel terrible about it. As if I was the only one with that stupid fucking opinion. That's another thing. It's like, as if your hate comment is like necessary. As if, oh, you're the only one that's thought of this amazing critique, this groundbreaking critique that no one else thought of. Like, oh, your nose is big. Oh, God.
Your observational skills?
Man, I respect that. And I am gonna go change my ways. Thank you. Thank you for that enlightenment, Buddha. Thank you.
Negativity. It's so great. It's so great to just spread negativity, huh? It just makes the world so much better, huh? When people are, like, shitting on it.
Like, why was I so offended by her voice that I had to tell her it was so bad? I mean, truthfully, I just thought it was gonna make this guy laugh, which is even worse,
okay? Putting someone else down for humor, that's the stupidest.
Unless it's a sibling again.
Rake that sibling.
And you know what? I think I went back and deleted that comment and I never left a hate comment again.
Like, it's hard enough to be a human being, you know? You don't have to, like, make it worse, right?
But kudos to those who take it. Nisha said something.
I'm gonna butcher this quote
to death, but it was essentially like, to those I love the most, I wish hardship and pain and suffering.
Essentially, that's the only way to have any sort of character or grow at all or step into your humanity. Do you know what I mean? And what it means to be a human.
And so, for those who do endure hate comments and assholes at the restaurant, fucking impatient, self-absorbed idiots on the daily, go you!
You're doing great. You're doing fucking wonderful. And you're gonna be better because of it. Anytime somebody judges you, that's your chance, baby. To rise from the ashes of the phoenix!
Ah!
What fork is this turning into? Some like ooey gooey love looking shit. Oh, look at the love is trying to take over the anger. It's trying to fight it, you guys. I'm not even controlling the paintbrush.
Has anyone here ever fallen in love? Have you ever fallen in love?
I like woke up one day and realized you were in it.
I remember the first time I said I love you to a guy. Hopefully he's not watching this video. It was an accident. I was like talking to him on the phone.
I always hang up with my parents and family members by saying love you, bye. It's like instinctually.
And we were on the phone and I had to go out. I was about to hang up. And I just was like, okay, love you, bye. Oh, I think we were FaceTiming. I was like, and he was like, ah! And I was like, I'm not insane. And then I hung up and I just smiled, you know? I was like, we've been dancing around it for a minute. And I was like, no, I'm not gonna say it because to me, that's the biggest thing you could ever say to someone is that you love them. To me, I just take it this way because, you know, I gotta have something. I gotta put something up there. What's the best thing you could ever say to someone? I love you. I think loving someone is the ultimate self-sacrifice because essentially, and this is going directly against what I said in my last video. I was like, oh, we only like each other because we're using each other to fill the void, fill loneliness, whatever. And then somebody lots of people commented, well, love is a two-way street. Yeah, you're benefiting, but someone else is too. And I thought about it even further and I was like, the people I love the most, I do the dirty work for. You know, like I put myself through pain for them. I actually do the opposite of what I want to do. And I make myself feel terrible because of how much I love them. The sun is reaching for the green. I think I love pretty quickly though. That's also the thing.
What the hell is that?
I'm painting.
What are you painting? Crap?
I'm painting my feelings, you insensitive prick.
Oh, dude, that looks like a third grader made it.
Like, I'm serious, dude. Try again. I'm serious.
I'm painting my feelings. I'm not painting a Picasso. I'm not painting a Van Gogh.
God, you see how the anger is gone? Like, I mean, it's still kind of here. So, but that's because this painting is a journey. That's what I love about theater. Like, you're just going to see a final product of this, but the theater is not some final snapshot. It's the whole experience, and then it's gone.
Now, I don't want to lose the anger because the anger is my passion and my fuel for life. You gotta want it, right? Like, when I'm feeling my fucking worst, I don't even want to feel better. I wouldn't even care to feel. I'm like, even if I felt better, like, what would that matter? Like, it's doesn't matter. Nothing fucking matters. So, you really gotta get angry because then it's like, then you have the need. The need to get out of this spell. It really is. It feels like a spell. Sometimes I feel like the simulation does that to people just to kind of shut them down. Because they're about to do too well. Or they're about to, I don't know. Now, I would call that little exchange between Sophia and I love. I would call it that because you know what it was? Honest. And that is true love. True love is honesty. Because being honest is one of the scariest things you can be with another person because it's vulnerable. You can get hurt. If you really love someone, you know that your honesty will not destroy the relationship. Unless what you did destroyed the relationship. Even then, like, if you're not a piece of shit person and you're willing to, like, work through it, then I think you can. You just have to build that trust again because if you don't have trust, you can't be honest. You can't be honest. You don't love somebody. Like, maybe you want to love them, but if you can't be honest with them, that's not love. That's selfish. That's fucking selfish if you're lying to someone. Lying is selfish. Who are you to think that you could twist somebody's view of reality? Who are you to fucking trick somebody or keep someone from the truth? You piece of shit. And for what? So that you can feel okay? So that you can keep feeling better? Or so that your life doesn't fucking change or spin upside down because you can't fucking tell the truth? That's bullshit. Bullshit I call bullshit! I value honesty, honestly, above everything else. Because everything starts with being honest. Courage. Okay, courage, that's a good value to have. What's courage if you're not an honest person? Like, what's anything if you're not honest, right? Like,
I don't know.
I think you have to be honest before you can be anything else. Whenever you're, like, afraid to be honest, that's shitty. Like, that's the shittiest feeling. Now, when it comes to, like, love and stuff, I think it gets a little bit, like, a little bit messy because, like, way back in high school,
please nobody be watching this video.
I was, like, in love with this guy. It was freshman year, and I would talk to his friend in class about him, and I was clearly, like, really into this other guy. And me and this guy that I would talk to, I thought were, like, really good friends, right? And then, you know what he does?
One day comes out and is like, Cascina, I have to tell you something. Will you be my girlfriend? I'm sorry. Huh?
I think in that situation, if you really cared about me and you weren't being selfish, you wouldn't ask that because I'm clearly in love with someone else. And I value our friendship. We were great friends. And he knew. That's the thing is like, I wasn't sending any mixed messages. And I know it's so hard not to like fall in love with your friends. But you know what? I think that's selfish. Because now I'm in this position of having to reject my friend because the truth is, I didn't want to just be his girlfriend. Not even like, hey, let's go on a date. We had never even hung out. It was just like, let's be my girlfriend. And I was just like, dude, like I loved this friendship. And it was fresh. It was like first semester of freshman year. Like I just met the dude. And I was literally head over heels in love with this fucking friend. And I told him all the time. I was like, bruh, like I hate that you've done this. Is that selfish of me?
I just don't think that I just got paint on my camera. It adds character.
Don't think that that was necessary. I think like give it maybe a few years or something. Like at least let me fall out of love with this other guy. Do you want to date someone that's in love with someone else?
Why don't you let them sort themselves out? If somebody like tells you
that they want somebody else.
You must be delusional to think
that they'll just drop that and start dating you.
Right?
Like, am I wrong about this? Do tell. Because when I told my cousin this, my very wise cousin, she was like, Cascina, you asshole. Well, he liked you. Is he wrong for liking you? I was like, well, no. It's not wrong to like someone at all. But I think that to put me in that sort of position where, like, we are friends, and I have romantic feelings for you, if I'm actively pursuing your friend, then you're gonna come on to me
like, oh my god.
If you could have just, like, waited for me to get through my shit, then, you know, like, things might have been different. Like, I don't know. It was just such bad time. Like, it's like, I get it. I get when you have those feelings that you just, like, you physically can't control them. You're like, oh my god, like, I'm obsessed with this person. Like, I just, god, that would just make me feel so good if, like, oh, I just need to tell them, like, that catharsis of, like, I love you, Snowman, it's you, like, I love you, but fucking hold that shit together. It could just be so much better if you could just, you know, like, I think movies ruin this for people, because, like, we all think that we have to have this big moment of, like, telling off a bully or, like, telling someone you love them, and it's like, that's, in general, like, I don't think that that's how that goes. There sometimes is a time for that. I'm not saying that doesn't ever happen, because, like, I'm sure it does. But it's not like when you're feeling it the most, you have to say it then and there. It's like, okay, I'm feeling it the most, but it's a terrible fucking time. So I'm gonna just swallow it, right? I don't think that that's unhealthy. I don't, like, my god, when I'm super fucking angry at people, I don't actually kill them. You know what I mean? Like, please, dear God, please. Like, why am I even saying this on the internet? I hear people over. This is why I don't like to talk. I think the point is, like, a huge part of, like, truly loving someone is that element of selflessness, where knowing that your own emotional catharsis is not the number one priority. If that's got, like, if you really love someone and you know that, like, this is unrequited, or, like, me saying this is, like, absolutely only gonna benefit me. Completely unnecessary.
Someone back me up in the comments!
I don't know. I'm just a fucking human. Why don't you just fucking cancel me? How about you just do that? That'd be great. It's so colorful, like, I feel like a really pretty black and white type of person, like, I mean, obviously, it's, like, all I wear, but this is just so full of color, like, it's kind of nice. I think artists, like, people who can draw and shit, are the coolest thing on the planet, because I don't understand it. It's something I'll never be able to do. Like, my doodles, like, it's so not what I meant to do. It just, they all look fucking terrible. I'm gonna put, like, little, like, people in here. A little family. Hello. They all live in this little, like, safe haven from all the nutty, the nuttiness of the world. Somewhere way out there, away from Earth. Aliens, come take me. Come take me away. I want to go with you. Aliens, I would like to live with you instead. I was, like, reading an AMA on Reddit and Ask Me Anything. With some, like, astronauts. And somebody said, like, what do you miss the most about Earth? And they were like, just the life. Like, literally a rabbit jumping across the park or some shit. Like, little things that are just not present on, like, the moon or in space or on Mars. Like, life. And that made me reappreciate this. Like, fuck. That's so true. I'm just so eager to leave and escape to some cold, barren rock. For what? Just to get away from the fucking humans? Like, it would be terrible, maybe. I mean, I still want to go. I still think I will. But I do not, maybe I won't get, like, a one-way. Maybe I actually will get a two-way. Come back. Maybe I'll come back. You know what? This is a great place to be. Namely because I can feel things. And there's not much to give you, like, any sort of feeling on a rock, like, on a barren rock. Like, there's no life to observe and, like, be affected by. And that is the beauty of this planet. The fucking life and the heart. Say what you will about America, and I have said what I will what I have. I have said what I have said about America. You know, I'm not shy about some of my hatred for what goes on in this country. But you know what? There's heart. At least we fucking care about something. Right? It's like, would you want to be in a relationship where you literally never fight? Maybe.
Maybe.
But like, there's no way that you'll agree on everything, right? Even with your bestest friends, you don't always fucking agree on literally everything. If somebody didn't care to ever disagree with you, what in the fuck does that mean? Like, I just don't want to be in the company of somebody who's like, doesn't care about anything. Because I am like that so often and I hate it. I hate it, and so I get mad about it, right? Like, that's enraging to, like, not care when you're literally a human. Like, what's more angering than not caring? Nothing. If you don't care, like, there's no reason to be, like, there's no reason to be here if you don't care. So, like, that pisses me off whenever I don't care, because I'm like, hello, this is your one fucking life. What are you doing sitting there like this? What the fuck are you doing? We make the meaning here. We make it. Get angry when they try and take this from you, because this is all, this, we were all given this, okay? We were all given this life. Every single being on the planet was given this opportunity to be here. So who the fuck are you to control somebody else's existence? Why would you give someone that power too? Like, why would you give all your freedom over to someone? What would you be wanting out of that? Because you're out of fear. I guess I would do it out of fear of, like, not being able to find a purpose of my own. Like, I would be like, yeah, you can give me one. I'll take your purpose for me, thanks. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm, like, droning on. But I'm liking this picture a lot. So, yeah, that's just where I'm at today. As we know, that's just today. And every day is a little bit fucky in its own special way. That does not look like the Earth whatsoever. That's our planet in the middle of colors and confusion and anger and love and hate and spirit and kindness and selfishness and selflessness. And it's all here. We can either see the beauty and love in that, or we can see the opportunity to exploit. And for what? This is actually fucking great, and I feel amazing now. So I might actually do this more often. Every time I look in there, I'm like, notice it looks terrible. That is where I think I'm gonna leave it for now. I might come down and ruin it somehow. It's the end of my kombucha. At the end of this vid. What if I painted my face?
I would love to do that. Just fucking...
What if I just hugged this and got it all over? Like, what if I just, like, ruined everything in this garage? I got a piece of... Pee-pee! Please interpret it how you will. Feel free. This is yours now. Alright, so I'm really gonna have direct. I'm burping. I'm hiccuping. I have to pee. I'm really not doing well. Sorry. Everything just sort of... malfunctioned at once. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next vid. Bye.